And finally, it may be Father's Day today, but there's one Elmore daddy who won't be celebrating. Richard Watterson has been revealed as Elmore's least law-abiding citizen. His antisocial behavior outnumbers the combined efforts of a teenager who looks like a bomb, a man who looks like a thumbprint, and the head of our local government. Elmore News reached out to the chief of police for comments, but he told us he wasn't there.
Can someone explain how this happens? We're the laughingstock of the policing community.
Outsmarted by a pink rabbit and a stupid crib on tie, I could lose my job over this, or at the very least my voice. What's more, there's not even anyone in this gosh-darn office! I gotta get to the bottom of this Watterson character. And to get to the bottom of anything, you gotta start at the top. No, wait, that's me. You gotta start near the top.
Sheriff, answer me this. Why is Richard Watterson at large?
Because he eats more calories than he burns.
I said at large, at large. You've had him in your sights on multiple occasions and let him go. Here, for example, when you could have arrested him for wasting police time.
Officer, please, I need to report a theft.
Yes, finally. What did the thief look like?
Well, he was wearing a monocle.
Uh-huh. Okay. Anything else?
Yes, he had a big furry mustache.
Uh-huh, big furry mustache. Okay, any other distinguishing features?
Yes, he was dressed as a yodeler. Aren't you going to write that down?
Just testing something. And what did that man steal?
A kiss.
Well, Chief, after we kissed, I thought it was kind of harsh to arrest him. I admire your gentlemanly conduct, officer, but that was not the first time he operated incognito. He has posed as Richard Watertash, Rachel Waterwig, Samantha Jones.
And when he was disguised as the infamous man mom, he evaded your entire force.
Hey, lady, pull over and step out of the stolen vehicle. Pull over and step out of the stolen vehicle.
And again, when he was disguised as a British fraudster, Dame Prunella, Big Red Boss.
Fish and chips.
So to recap, Gumball and I will sneak into the hospital and give each other facial reconstructive surgery to make us look like the two highest achievers at school, simultaneously paying off our debts and allowing us to replace them at school.
Oh, perfect and simple. What could go wrong?
300 pounds of blubber wearing kitten heels and you still couldn't catch him? And then look at his road traffic offenses. They're off the chart.
Richard, do you have the card?
Sure.
Thanks.
Apologies, Chief. Looks like I really dropped the ball with Watterson.
You did more than drop a ball. You totally mishandled the situation. Now, here's his address. Go get him.
Okay, boss, I'm on my way. The traffic's pretty bad out here.
Maybe try the cybercrime department first.
I like your thinking, officer.
Ah, friend request. Oh, no, it's the boss.
Say, you got any dirt on a guy named Richard Watterson?
Don't talk to me about Watterson.
Oh, okay. Bye. Well, that was impertinent.
That was a figure of speech, boss. That man is the greatest threat to home computing since the smartphone. Just look at his irresponsible online game reviews.
So yeah, I found another cool little game built into the OS. It's called Character Map. You start by choosing your character name. I'm gonna go with this little fella here, Frizz Quadrata Thin. There isn't a Frizz Quadrata Overweight, which is a little discriminatory, but it doesn't affect the gameplay. And then you choose a column and the story kind of unfolds. For example, you search for the money in a long, thin maze. But there's a ghost in there. Nice little in-joke. So you end up needing new underpants. So you have to drive to the store, but oh no, you hit a dead end. Now, I got a neat little cheat code for you to get out of this. You just switch to a thing called system and erase that last move. So, erase drive, and that solves the...
Okie dokie. So then you type erase drive and... Oh, can't believe I did it again. Such addictive gameplay.